Today I will discuss the use of pinhole in ophthalmology. Pinhole allows only single ray to pass through the eye and focus on the retina. To explain this, let's consider an example. Suppose this is an eye and AB is an object. In a normal patient or in a normal eye, the light rays coming from the object are focused evenly on the retina and a clear cut image is formed. But in the case of refractive error, for example myopia, hypermetropia, what happens is that rays of light coming from the object are not focused on the retina but maybe in front of the retina in case of myopia, or behind the retina in case of hypermetropia. As a result, the image formed on the retina is not as clear as compared to the patient who is normal. So pinhole basically allows us to detect whether decreased visual acuity or vision is due to refractive error or any other ocular pathology or neurological disease. How to do it? The procedure for pinhole is that put pinhole in trial frame in front of the eye being tested and occlude the other eye. Then ask the patient to read Snellen chart or ETDRS chart or any other vision chart. Now what you have to note is that if visual acuity improves with pinhole, it means that decreased vision is due to refractive error. But if visual acuity does not improve with pinhole, that indicates that patient has any ocular pathology or any neurological disease. But do remember that in case of macular diseases, visual acuity with pinhole is even worse as compared to unaided visual acuity. This is because pinhole is basically allows only a single image from the center to pass and focus on the macula. Macula is part of the retina and it is the area of sharpest vision. So in diseases that affect this macula, the image formed is not as clear as it is in a normal eye. So this is the use of pinhole in ophthalmology, and it helps us to decide whether decreased visual acuity is due to uncorrected refractive error or any ocular pathology.